Hello everyone, welcome to Automobile Engineering class. I am V. Rakesh, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department. In this session, I am talking about friction clutch and types of friction clutches, its advantages, disadvantages, applications. Friction clutch. The purpose of friction clutches is to connect a moving member to another that is moving at a different speed or stationary, often to synchronize the speeds and to transmit power. Usually, as little slippage, that means difference in speeds, as possible between the two members is desired. Now, see the principle of a friction clutch. A clutch works on the principle of friction. It can be explained by considering two shafts. This is the driving shaft, this is the driven shaft, and two discs. This is the driving disc, this is the driven disc. Let shaft A and disc B, let shaft A and disc B are made to revolve at a speed of n, at a speed of n rpm, and a disc D. Now assume this is the disc D and this is the shaft C. A disc D key to a shaft C are at rest position initially, that is clutch is not engaged. Then some force W is applied axially to the disc D and is made to come in contact with the disc B. Then due to the force of friction between the disc B and disc D will start revolving. Speed of the disc D depends on the frictional force and is proportional to the force W is applied. As the axial force W increases, speed increases, and the speed of the disc B will be equal to the speed of the disc D. At this stage, the clutch is said to be fully engaged. See here, this is the disengaged position, this is the fully engaged position. Torque transmitted by the friction clutch depends on the three parameters, that is T equal to mu WR, where mu equal to coefficient of friction, W is axial force applied on the disc D, R is the main effective radius of the frictional force. This is the brief discussion about principle of a friction clutch. Now see the types of friction clutches. Before going to explain types of clutch, now see the material characteristics for friction surfaces. It should have a high and uniform coefficient of friction. It should not be affected by moisture and oil. It should have the ability to withstand high temperature caused by slippage. It should have high conductivity. It should have high resistance to wear and scoring. Next topic is types of friction clutches. Friction clutches are divided into five types: single plate clutch, multi plate clutch, cone clutch, centrifugal clutch, semi centrifugal clutch. Now see the brief discussion about each and every clutch in next slides. In this first one is single plate clutch. See this figure, it consists of flywheel, clutch plate, pressure plate. This pressure plate is attached to this cover, and this cover is attached to this flywheel with the help of bolts and struts. This single plate, both hands having friction materials. A single plate is commonly used in cars and light vehicles. It has only one clutch plate, which is mounted on the splines of the clutch shaft. A flywheel is mounted on the crankshaft of the engine. This type of a clutch employs a disc whose both sides are fixed with a friction material. It is also called as clutch plate. The disc is known as clutch plate or clutch disc. This flywheel is connected to the engine and the clutch disc is connected to the transmission. A pressure plate is, see here, this is the pressure plate. This pressure plate is connected to the flywheel through the bolts and clutch springs. It is free to slide. It is free to slide on the clutch shaft with the movement of the clutch pedal. Now see the working of single plate clutch. When the clutch pedal is depressed, the flywheel and the pressure plate, the flywheel and the pressure plate will disengage and the clutch disc will be no longer in contact with the flywheel. Consequently, no transmission power will be performed by the clutch. This is the disengaged position of single plate clutch. Now see this figure. When the clutch pedal is released, the pressure plate will once again press the clutch disc against the flywheel and the disc will be sandwiched between the flywheel and the pressure plate. The engine power will therefore be transmitted to the transmission in such a situation. This is the engaged position of single plate clutch. Now see the advantages of single plate clutch. The gear changing is very easy. It is more reliable as compared to cone clutch. Now see the disadvantages. The force required by the driver for disengaging the clutch is more as springs are stiff. Second one is multi plate clutch. It also consists of clutch discs. In this we are using more than one clutch. This is the flywheel, these are the clutch discs, this is the separator, this is the pressure plate. A multi-plate clutch is a type of clutch system where multiple driven and drive plates are used in order to make up for torque loss due to slippage. A multiple clutch is provided with more than one friction plate. In this clutch, there are pressure plates and two friction plates. These pressure plates are linked to the clutch cover by means of struts. This clutch cover is fitted to the flywheel. One friction plate is placed between the first and second pressure plate, and the other one is between the second and flywheel. A multi-plate clutch can transmit large torque. The link mechanism is the same as the one used in single plate clutch. The two friction plates are connected to the shaft. These two friction clutches are connected to the clutch shaft by means of a spline arrangement. While the flywheel is rotating, the pressure plates rotate and press against the friction plate. This causes the friction plates and the clutch shaft to rotate as well. When the pedal is pressed, the flywheel continues to rotate. but the friction plates are released. This happens because they are not fully pressed by the pressure plate. Thus, the clutch shaft also stops rotating. This is the working of multi-plate clutch. This type of clutches are used in racing cars and heavy motor vehicles which have high engine power. Next one is types of multi-plate clutch. These multi-plate clutches are divided into two types. One is multi-plate wet clutch. This type of clutch consists of thin plates of steel fitted to the engine shaft, that means drive shaft, and those on clutch shaft, that is driven shaft, are made of Passper branch. These plates are immersed in a bath of oil and also have grooved surface for allowing the oil to flow through them. These grooves help to dissipate the heat generated during engagement and release operations. Second one is this multi-plate wet clutches are generally used together with as a part of automobile transmission. This type of multi-plate wet clutches are used in automatic transmission. Second one is multi-plate dry clutch. This type of clutch has plates. This type of clutch has plates lined with a similar friction material as that used in case of a single plate clutch. Now see the advantages of multi-plate clutches. The number of friction surfaces increases the capacity of the clutch to transmit torque, though the size remains fixed. Therefore, considering the same torque transmission, the overall diameter of the multi-plate clutch is reduced when compared to a single plate clutch. Due to this advantage, this type of clutch is used in some heavy transport vehicles and racing cars. This multiple clutch is used in scooters and motorcycles where it is limited. Next one is cone clutch. See this figure. A cone clutch was extensively used in automobiles, but nowadays it has been completely replaced by the disc clutch. It consists of two cones having a pair of friction surface. The cones are known as male cone or driven. This is the outer cone is also called as female cone or driver cone. In a cone clutch, the female cone is key to the engine shaft, that means driving shaft, by a sun key and has an inside conical surface or face which exactly fits into the outside conical surface of the male cone. The male cone is splined on the clutch shaft, that is driven shaft, and may be shifted along the shaft by a fork lever provided in order to engage the clutch by bringing the two conical surfaces, that means male cone and female cone, in contact. Due to the frictional resistance setup at this contact surface, the torque is transmitted from one shaft to another shaft. A spring is placed around the clutch shaft in contact with the hub of the male cone. Now see the advantages of cone clutches. The normal force acting on the friction, that means contact surface, is greater than the axial force in comparison to single plate clutch, in which the normal force is acting on the surfaces is equal to the axial force. See here, this the normal force is Q. Q equal to axial force is P by cos alpha this is the alpha means semi angle semi cone angle this P is the axial force this is the Q is the normal force the force acting on the clutch cone clutch that is Q equal to or you can take Wn or Q your wish Wn equal to W by cos alpha here I have taken P and Q so Q equal to P by cos alpha in this alpha is semi cone angle Q is the axial force P is the axial force Q is the normal force now see the disadvantage of cone clutches if the angle of cone is made smaller than 20 degrees the male cone tends to bend in the female cone and it becomes difficult to disengage the cone disengage the clutch a small amount of wear on the cone surface results in a considerable amount of axial movement of the male cone for which it will be difficult to allow. These are the few disadvantages of cone clutches. Next one is centrifugal clutch. The centrifugal clutch uses centrifugal force instead of spring force, keeping the clutch in engaged position. This type of clutch does not require any clutch pedal for operating the clutch. Since there is no clutch pedal, therefore the clutch is operated automatically depending upon the engine speed. It may be noted that the vehicle can be stopped in gear without stalling the engine. Stalling means stopping. Similarly, the vehicle can be started in any gear by pressing the accelerator pedal. Now see the construction and working of centrifugal clutch. See this figure, it consists of weights A, this is the fixed pivot B, this is the ball crank lever, this one is the flywheel, this is the clutch plate, this is the pressure plate, these are the springs. It consists of weights A, pivoted at fixed point pivot B. When the engine speed increases, the weights tends to move outward. That means this side. When the engine speed increases, the weights tends to move outwards due to centrifugal force operating the bell crank levers. This action presses the pressure plate C through the spring D, which ultimately presses the driven clutch plate E on the flywheel. This makes the clutch's engaged position. At low engine speeds, only spring pressure acts, while at a high engine speed, the force generated by the weight supplement the spring pressure. The smooth and acceptable gear changes are obtained under varying conditions of the load and speed. Now see the advantages of centrifugal clutch. There is no clutch pedal. No clutch pedal is required for operating the clutch. It is operated automatically depending upon the engine speed. The vehicle can be started and stopped in any gear. Disadvantage of centrifugal clutch. Sometimes engines suffer from slippage in lower RPM. It cannot be used in a high speed engine. Peak speed depends on clutch size. Last one is semi-centrifugal clutch. Before going to explain semi-centrifugal clutch, now discussing about applications of centrifugal clutch. Centrifugal clutch is generally used in vehicles. This centrifugal clutch is widely used in industrial applications like machinery, mining, military, manufacturing purposes. In chemical industries, the centrifugal clutch is used in mixers, used in lawn mowers, chainsaw, used in scooters, go-karts, and mopeds. During stalling in paramotors and boats, centrifugal clutch is used to keep this stalling, and during idling and start of the engagement of the loads are done by centrifugal clutch. These are the few applications of centrifugal clutch. Last one is semi-centrifugal clutch. The semi-centrifugal clutch uses both centrifugal force as well as spring force for keeping it in engaged position. The springs are designed to transmit the torque at moderate or normal speeds, while the centrifugal force assist in torque at higher speeds. Now see the construction and working of semi-centrifugal clutch. See this figure, it consists of flywheel. This is the clutch plate, this is the clutch spring, this is the cover, this one the lever. A typical semi-centrifugal clutch consists of three hinged and weighted levers and three clutch springs. These are alternately arranged at equal spaces on the pressure plate. The details of one lever as shown this right side figure. The lever having a fulcrum at A and is hinged to pressure plate at B. The upper end of the lever is weighted at C. The maximum centrifugal force on the pressure plate can be adjusted by this adjusting screw D. Now see the functions of semi-centrifugal clutch. At moderate or normal speeds, the pressure of the spring is sufficient to transmit the required torque. In this condition, the weighted levers do not apply any pressure on the pressure plate. Second one is, at higher speeds, the weights attached to the lever moves out due to the centrifugal force about fulcrum, thereby pressing the pressure plate. It may be noted that the centrifugal force is proportional to the square of the speed, hence adequate means sufficient pressure is achieved. When the speed decreases, the weights fall and the levers do not exert any pressure on the pressure plate. Only the spring pressure is exerted on the pressure plate, which is sufficient to keep the clutch engaged. These are the few functions of a semi-centrifugal clutch. Now see the advantages of semi-centrifugal clutch. Less stiff springs of the clutches at low speed. There is no strain for clutch operations. Disadvantage of semi-centrifugal clutch. At a normal speed of an engine, the clutch is designed to send torque spring, assist the torque transmission at the high speed engine by centrifugal force. These are the few advantages and disadvantages of semi-centrifugal clutch. This is the brief discussion about types of friction clutches. In the coming session, I will going to explain other types of clutches. Thank you for watching. Please do like and subscribe my channel for more updates.